So once again, for me, Jon Wynand and Salt and Lighting, a great privilege to spend some time with your children, teachers and parents, and to talk to you about children with character as salt and light. And once again, I want to talk to you about a big word, integrity. But integrity is one of the values that we need when we want to be the salt and light of this earth. But what does integrity mean? The dictionary explains it like this. It is the quality of honesty and strong moral principles. It also means to have moral justice. Synonyms for integrity are honesty, justice, your word is your honor, good character, principle, ethically correct, morally worthy, and righteousness. Simply, integrity means knowing the right thing to do and doing those right things, even when there is no one who sees you. But what does the Bible say about integrity? Let's have a look at Proverbs 11 verse 3. The integrity of the upright will guide them, but the perversity of the unfaithful will destroy them. When you have integrity, you will have an upright life. But if you do not have integrity, the opposite is perversity. And for the unfaithful, it will destroy them. Integrity is part of our character. God wants us to look more and more like Jesus. Our character is very important to Him. The word used instead of integrity is to complete or be upright or be perfect. That means you are created perfect by God. You were made to His image. He made you look like Him. God is your daddy and you are as He made you. So if you have integrity, you are an upright person and you are doing what is right. But how does this all fit in with salt and light? In today's world, we see very few people with integrity doing what's right. But when you see it, it stands out like a sore thumb for everyone to see. It is precisely those who have integrity who will be salt and light. You are going to be making a difference where you are. If you do not have integrity and you boast that you are a child of God, you do not only damage your own name, but also God's name. If you do not have integrity, you are certainly not salt and light that stands out and make the world a better place. Your lifestyle should be a good example. There is a world out there that never goes to church or does not even have Bibles to read. You may be the only Bible that a person may get to see in his life. You may be the only example on how to live with integrity. If you do not live with integrity, that person does not want to get to know God. There's a man named Gandhi. Now, he was a man from India who gained a lot of fame through the way he lived. He was dealing with people who called themselves Christians, and his reaction was, "I love your Jesus, but I do not like your Christians. Your Christians are not like your Jesus." The image he has of Christians got him to believe that he would rather not have anything to do with our faith. The Christians he met did not live like Jesus. They did not have integrity. So how are we going to manage to live with integrity now? Let's have a look in Ecclesiastes 12 verse 13 and 14 in the Bible. It says, "Fear God and keep His commandments, for this is man's all. For God will bring every work into judgment, including every secret thing, whether good or evil." So we must be honest in the little things where people can see you, but also where people cannot see you. God sees everything we do, and people see what you do not know they see. Instead, do everything with integrity. Integrity must be visible everywhere in your life. Handle your property and other people's property with integrity, including your schoolwork, homework, sport, and cultural activities. How to treat people, especially those who are weaker or smaller than you, will show if you have integrity. It is all about the right thing to do. It's not about what's easier to do. There are rules in life that we must follow, God's rules, and those rules do not change if it is a difficult situation. Just like God never changes, His rules do not change either. Integrity must be carried out with consistency. What you say and what you do must always match. You must live disciplined. Always do what you say. A clever man named John Ortberg once said, "People with integrity do the right thing at the right time, in the right way, and for the right reason, just like Jesus. This is how we will be salt and light and change the world. Now, my friends, children with character and with integrity, pray together because we need God's help. Let's pray. Father God, thank you for making me in your image. Thank you for creating me perfect, and that integrity is part of my character, a character that comes straight from you. Please help me to know what the right thing to do is, and to do those right things for the right reasons and the right way. Please forgive me where I damage your name. I would like to be someone the world can look up to, and for them to see what it means to be a Christian. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen. My dear friends, it was wonderful for Salty and Lighty and myself to spend some time with you and to talk to you again about children with character are salt and light. And remember, people with integrity do the right thing at the right time, in the right way, and for the right reason. Let's go out there and live with integrity so that people can see who Jesus is. I'm looking forward to spending some time with you again. Until next time, goodbye.
Just as you are to worship, come. Just as you are before your God, come. One day every tongue will confess you are God. One day every knee will bow. Still the greatest treasure remains for those who gladly choose you now. Come, now is the time to worship. Come, now is the time to give your just as you are to worship. Come, just as you are before your God. Come. One day every tongue will confess you are God. One day every knee will bow. Still the greatest treasure remains for those who gladly choose Him are to worship. Just as you are before your God.